What was the job of Aristocles? Aristocles, better known to his friends as Wide Boy. It also means flat, oddly enough. It means wide and flat.
Flat.
Flatulence.
What's a flat-billed sort of animal called?
Duck. Duck-billed platypus.
Plato is the answer.
Plato is the answer.
Yes, he was. His real name was Aristocles, and he was known as the wide one.
Plato's real name was Aristocles.
Aristocles. He was nicknamed Plato. There he is.
Oh, my word, he went to a terrible sculptor. It must be so upsetting when you... I love when they put the mirror behind you and pull it out like that.
May I ask who sculpted you last, sir? Plato was indeed the schoolboy nickname of Aristocles from the Greek wide, and it was given to him because of his broad shoulders. His real name was Aristocles, and Aristocles taught Aristotle. And what did Aristotle teach us, the world, about buzzards?
Oh, this would be something absurd because...
He did say something absurd
about it. It'd be ridiculous. It'll be something that they can read our minds or something like that.
No,
he felt that there were birds who didn't realise they were buzzards, and it was building up inside that they were latent buzzards.
Latent Way hey. You get five for something there. I don't quite know what it is, Ron, but you get five for something. I'll tell you the answer. Actually, what he thought they had three testicles.
Oh, you see, this is the sort of thing he comes out with all the time. He's very overrated. Even though he knew a good sculptor, he looks all right there. Yeah. Look at the robe on him.
There's a really interesting thing I can tell you about buzzards, on the other hand. The Latin for buzzard, its taxonomical name, is Buteo buteo, right? Now, there's a sort of, as it were, a subspecies of buzzard called a hobby, and it is Subbuteo.
Oh, God. Subbuteo. Oh.
And the man who invented a game wanted to call it the hobby, and when he tried to patent it, they wouldn't let him use the word the hobby, so he called it after the Latin name for the hobby, which is Subbuteo.
And that's why one is kicking a little testicle around the ball.
If you like. Now it all comes back. Amazing. That's where the name Subbuteo comes from.
It must be great to be a philosopher. None of us could sit there and count the testicles on a buzzard and really explain it or justify it. What are you doing? I'm counting the balls on a buzzard. Some better things you... Well, I'm a philosopher. Oh, well, go ahead.
Yeah. Did you know that the Pope, when the Pope is elected, still has to have this ceremony in the Vatican? After the Pope is elected, the Pope is carried over a group of the cardinals. And now, of course, the Pope actually doesn't display himself, but in days gone by, he would display himself. And the cardinals, this still happens to this day, when the Pope is crowned, the cardinals, the Pope is carried on a chair over the cardinals, and they look up and they say, testiculus habet et bene pendentes.
No. And this
is, yes, it is.
He has balls
true.
That he's well hung.
No.
Bene pendentes.
It means that they are well hung. They are hanging well. And it goes back to the time of Pope Joan, when a girl masqueraded as a young pope. And since that's when the ceremony was introduced. And so the tradition continues to this day.
Fabulous. 5 points. Brilliant. I love it.
Well done.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.